click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll learn how to create the slide assembly in SOLIDWORKS part 1. So here we'll be creating the slide and the stairs for the slide assembly. So let's see. Now let's see how to create the staircase assembly. So we'll first create the slide. So for that, go in the new tab, select the part, click OK. Now first I will select the front plane to create the slide. So I will just create the sketch for the slide. So select the center point arc, select the center and take the radius of 100. We'll just create one semicircle. Now again go in the 3-point arc. Now here draw arc of radius 11. Go in the add relation. Now select this point and this point and make them properly horizontal. Again go in the add relation, select the origin point, the center point, make them horizontal. Select one center line and draw one center line here. So we'll just mirror this arc to left hand side. Now go in the smart dimension, select the origin point, this end point. It is already fully defined. It is showing me underdefined, so I will just again go in the add relation, select the origin point, this point, and make them horizontal. Now our sketch is fully defined. Exit the sketch. Now select the right plane, click on the sketch, make it normal too. Select the line command. Here draw one line of say 200. Again select the line command. Here draw the sketch. Go in the smart dimension and take the distance between these two as 650. I'll just delete this distance and take it with respect to the origin. Now select both this line and take the angle of 120. Go in the smart dimension and take this as 150. Now just exit the sketch. Now here go in the surface, select the swept surface. So this will be our profile and this will be our path. Just click OK. I'll just change the view to shaded. I'll just go in the sketch and increase the angle. Now just exit the sketch. Okay. Now it is properly looking. So I'll just add some appearance. Now just save this part. So click on save as. We'll just create one new folder. Here we'll put one slide assembly. Here I'll give the name as slide and save this part. Now again click on the new tab, select the part, click OK. I will make the stairs. So again select the front plane, click on the sketch, select the circle and take the circle of diameter 20, exit the sketch. Now select the right plane, click on the sketch, make it normal too. Now select the line command. Now just create the shape for the stair. Now just exit the sketch, select the swept surface. Or here this is a, basically this will be a solid body, so we'll select here features and we'll select the swept boss feature. So select this and this line. I'll just go in the sketch and assign the dimensions first. So here go in the smart dimension, select the origin and take this as 650. Let this be as 200 and take this as 150. Now just show this plane. I will just create one reference plane. Just select this plane and take the distance as 111. Click OK. I will use this place as mirror plane. I will go in the mirror, select this plane, and now go in the bodies to mirror and select this body. Click OK. It is showing some error, so we'll select again. We just try to mirror at a feature. Just click this merge solid off, select this and click OK. See, now it will be creating the mirror body. Now just select this plane, click on the sketch, make it normal too. Select the circle command and draw one circle here. Take the diameter as 15. Exit the sketch, select the extrude boss command, select this circle, here select the option up to surface and select this surface, click OK. Now we'll pattern this. I'll just hide this plane. Now here select the curve driven pattern. So before that I will just show this curve which will be using as a pattern. So just click here and show this. Now go in the curve driven pattern. Here select the curve and now select the features to pattern. So we'll select this. Now here I will just untick this equal spacing. I'll take this distance as 75. It has created the proper steps. I'll just click OK. Now our stair is ready. just give some material to this. So go in the edit material. We'll select this carbon steel, apply, just close it. Now again go in the save as and save this as stair. Click OK. Now we have created a stair in the slide. That is a straight slide. Now we will create other slide that will be a curved. So we'll see both the assemblies. So again click on the new sketch, select the part, click OK, select the front plane, select the sketch. Now we'll use the same profile as we have used for the swap. So select the center point arc. Now here we'll take the radius as 100, which we have used for the earlier slide. I'll just select the circle and here I'll draw a circle of diameter 200. Just select one center line. Now we'll go in the sketch, select the 3-point arc. I'll just create a 3-point arc and take the radius as 11. Again we'll just mirror this, so I will select the center line, select the mirror entities, select this arc and select the mirror line. Now just go in the smart dimension, select this point, take the distance as 122. Now the sketch is fully defined. Now this profile is same as the earlier, but we'll create one different path here. For that select the right plane, click on the sketch, make it normal to, select the line command, draw one line of 200. Again select the line command. Now here I'll just create one arc of radius 1000. Again select the line command and draw one line further. Just make it horizontal. Go in the add relation, select this arc and this line and make them tangential. Go in the smart dimension, select the origin point. And the end point. Take the distance as 650. Just delete this. Go in the smart dimension. Select the origin point. This point. And take it as 650. We'll just take this as 1000 first. As it is of radius 1000 only, so it will just take the distance as 1000. So we'll just go in the smart dimension and we'll just assign the distance here, say as 120. See, now the sketch is fully defined. I'll just exit the sketch, go on the surface, select the swept surface, select this profile, this path, click OK. I'll just go ahead and select the shaded view. This is the other slide, so I'll just add some appearance. I'm adding this appearance. Just go and save it. Just give it as a name, slide 2. Now we'll see the assembly. So just close this, click on the new tab, select the assembly modeling, click OK. Now just open the first slide. Now go in the insert component and select the stair. Just open it. I'll just go in the rotate and just rotate this. Now it has properly rotated, so I'll just bring it near to the slide. Go in the mate, select this circular profile and this circular profile, make them properly concentric. Same for the other side, select the circular face and this circular face, make them concentric. Like this, you can simply create one assembly of the slide. I will just create a ball as it as you want to just slide from here. For that, I will just go in the new part, click OK, select the front plane, just draw one circle of diameter 98, and just take the diameter as 198, select the center line, just trim the other half. Go in the features and select the revolve base. Click yes. Now see, it has created a circular ball. So I'll just save this. And click save the name as ball. Just close this. I will insert that ball here to get the proper movement. I'll just place this ball somewhere here. We'll just go here and just show its origin. It is already shown. I will just go in the slide, go in the surface, I'll just show the path. Now go in the mate, go in the advanced mate, select the path mate. Now here you have to select the vertex. I will just show the origin. So this will be our vertex. Now we are set to path. So I'll just select this path and click OK. It will just slide in the given path. See, like this, you can create a simple assembly. And now we'll just see the assembly of the second slide. So just go here, select the assembly, Click OK. I'll select the slide 2. Open it. The assembly mates will be same. We'll just see. Click on the insert component. Select the same stair. Select the rotate component. Just rotate the stair. Go in the mate. Select this circular face and the bottom circular face of the slide. Make them concentric. Same for the other side. Select this circular face and this circular profile. Make them concentric. I'll just take it outward. You can just go in the lock, select this and this part and just make them lock. So it will be properly locked and that will not rotate anywhere or move anywhere. See, it is now properly fixed. So again, I will just insert the ball to get the sliding movement. So just select the ball, insert it. Again, go here. Select this and show the path. Again, go in the mates. Select the advanced mate. Select the path mate here. Just show the origin. Just select this origin. Now select the path. Click OK. Now this will be sliding over the given path. Like this, you can just simply model a sliding assembly in SOLIDWORKS, and you can just create the base if you want. Thank you, friends, for watching this video.